Hi, supply chain friends, Martin here. And in today's video, we're not just scratching the surface, we're going to deep dive and unlock and reveal the hidden value in your SAP system. Ready for this journey? Okay, let's get going. In this video, we're going to explore the ABC indicator and how to put it to best use. So Monique, why don't you tell us a bit about what to do about the ABC indicator and how best to use it in our supply chain?
Well, Martin, when I was running my warehouse, I use the ABC indicator to drive our cycle count program. It is one of the tools that supports grouping and segmentation to drive focus and attention based on the use, importance, or velocity of that particular material. Now, there are actually two ABC indicators. The one I mentioned that relates to warehouse ops and the one that I used was the MRP 1 tab. SAP can actually help us to set or determine values for either. But today I'm going to focus on the one in the MRP view, which is used for material selection, reporting, and analysis. Many people are unaware that SAP does this, so I'm looking forward to this one. So let's dig in. Now, I mentioned that there are two ABC indicators. The one folk tend to be most familiar with is the one that drives the cycle count program. But have you ever noticed that there's also one on the MRP 1 view? Let's go take a look. I'm going to go into the material master for this guy by double-clicking on the material number. Here we go. And you can see this is the field. Now this field, unlike the other ABC indicator that controls the cycle counting program, this one is for informational and reporting purposes only. It's very powerful information and we can use it in a number of ways for decision-making and cadence of activities in particular. It requires a regular review and maintenance. Now, did you know that SAP can help you both evaluate and update the ABC indicator? Yeah, it's pretty awesome, and you actually have two options for how to review and determine what that ABC indicator should be. You can look at either usage or requirements. So backwards based on historical consumption or forward-looking based on expected future volumes. Let's head over here and take a look.